Hi everyone, welcome back to the greenhouse. In today's video we are going to be talking about Venus flytraps. I'm going to give you a few care and cultural tips that will make growing these guys really easy, and you'll have lots of success with them just like I do. Now, one of the misconceptions about Venus flytraps is that they're actually really hard to grow, and that is a total misconception. They just need to be grown in the correct way. These guys don't make good houseplants. What you should be doing with them is replicating what they would naturally go through in their environment, which is in the Carolinas. So in the Carolinas, the summer times are warm and humid, so you're going to want to replicate warmth and humidity for the summertime. The spring and the fall are going to cool down just like everywhere, and then for the winter time, they're going to want to go dormant. So in the Carolinas, the weather is going to be hovering just around zero, sometimes a little bit below, sometimes a little bit above, but for December, January, and February, you want your Venus flytraps to undergo dormancy. If you were to leave them in the house or in a heated greenhouse like this here, then after 1 or 2 years of not going dormant, they're actually going to just start to wither and die. They need the dormancy in order to gain strength for the following growing season. Now, another thing to look for here, I've got some Venus flytraps set out on this table here. Another thing about them is they want no nutrients in their soil. We use a peat and perlite mix here in the greenhouse, and it works very well. So you never want to fertilize the Venus flytraps, and you want them to naturally catch their own bugs or feed them a fly or two every once in a while. Do not feed the Venus flytraps hamburger or anything like that. Another thing you'll notice is they are in a tray of water, so we want to make sure the Venus flytrap never dries out. They grow in boggy conditions in the Carolinas, and never allowing them to dry out is going to be one of the major things to keep these guys healthy. They come in all kinds of varieties here. So you can see this guy here. And this guy here. This one actually even has a flower. And this is my main colony here in the big pot. This is just original Venus flytraps. No special cultivators, but I've been growing them for a few years in here, and they've been really multiplying. This started as one, and look how many are in there now. I like to put them in a deep pot because the roots do like to go deep down into the soil, and it makes it easier for watering. Anyways, guys, hopefully with these few tips, you're going to be able to keep your Venus flytraps healthy and happy as well. If you like this video, make sure you hit the like button, and if you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. Oh, missed me.